friends. Can we check out the tiffintech merch? The merch that isn't merch because I'm not selling it. Right now, anyways. Maybe one day. But for now, just internally. High energy, Tiffany. Okay. Ooh. Take two, take three, take four, I don't know. Today, we are going to be talking about my journey into developer advocacy and developer relations. This is a question I've been getting asked a lot recently is, what exactly is a developer advocate? What do you do? And today I want to talk to you about what I do. Coming from 5 years of strictly software development into developer relations, I'm going to share with you about what I do on a day-to-day basis, what it really entails to be a developer advocate, and hopefully give you kind of more insight into what I do, but also to the role itself. And if I seem a little confused when I say that, it's because giving you insight into the role itself really varies company to company, person to person. And I'll get more into that throughout this video, but hopefully you will leave this video with knowledge on what the heck do I do, and also what a developer advocate is, to maybe see if it's right for you. Maybe you're a software developer right now, maybe you're in tech in another area, or maybe you're just getting into tech and want to know about it. Also, before we get into it, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, career, life videos. Leave in the comments other topics you want me to cover. As you know, this is how I make my videos, is based on what questions you have, what you want to hear from me. Okay, let's get started. I will go somewhere else. Okay, when I started making this video, I was going to do it vlog style, and I promise you more vlogs are coming to tiffintech about my day-to-day routine, but as many days, they're crazy busy, so rather than vlogging, I'm just gonna walk you through my day. The first thing I've been doing recently in the morning, actually, before we get into developer relations and that, just to tell you a little bit about my morning, is I've been going to work out in the morning. So I get up at 6 every day, leave the house by around 6:30, and go to Pilates, and this has really helped me gain focus throughout the day. I felt like my days were often so fuzzy and I was tired and I just needed that boost of energy. And honestly, working out in the morning has been a huge savior for that. I feel like then now throughout my days, I'm more productive, more focused, and honestly, more happy. When I get back from my workout, I always take some time to do some tiffintech emails and focus on that for the first part from, I would say, about 8 to 9. My workout's from 7 to 7:50, get back, do tiffintech content and emails, and then at 9, I start my day. Now, there are really three main areas that I focus on in developer advocacy. One being developer education, another being content, and the last being community. And a lot of times these three pillars overlap, of course, you know, with content being for developers, with community intertwining with developer experience. So it's all kind of intertwined in a way, or oftentimes it is, but then there are times where the content is on its own, the community is on its own focus, and the developer education is as well. And why at the beginning of this video I was like kind of looking confused or laughing to myself is because from company to company, developer advocacy or developer relations can really vary. And what I mean by that is I was actually just looking at job postings for developer advocates, not because I'm looking for a job at all, but because I just like to see what other companies are looking for, what they're doing in that space. I just find it really interesting and good to ensure that the skills I am building and working towards align with what is in demand, of course. And at the end of the day, the most important thing is serving the company I'm working at and ensuring that we're meeting our goals and finding ways to do that, that I'm growing as well too. So one of the things I noticed though is there's a lot of variety that can happen in these job postings. So for example, I saw a company hiring for a developer advocate, and half of the time, it said 50% of the time you will be coding. And then there's some developer advocates where they work under the marketing team. So they actually don't code that much, but you have to have a very strong knowledge of technology, of coding, depending on what the product is that you are advocating for. So what is a developer advocate? I'm actually gonna get my phone and see what it says on here, on the internet. The internet knows all. What is a developer? This is what it says, the first thing that comes up for me anyways. A developer advocate acts as the liaison between an organization and its relevant developer community or communities. The main responsibilities are to help the developer community do better work faster and more efficiently. And yeah, I would agree with that for the most part. I think that sums it up in a pretty nice nutshell. Okay, my camera just died. Let me though go back a little bit. I was thinking while it was charging actually about how to frame this. So I want to share with you exactly why I ended up going into developer relations and leaving software development on its own. I had been doing software development full time, both front and back end for 5 years, and it was great. I got promoted at my last company to senior developer very quickly. I started to lead a team of developers. It was great. I was working in Angular at the time, really enjoying it, and everything was going good. So many skills that I wasn't utilizing doing purely software development. And I think one of the main things was I really wanted to start connecting with others, talking to other people, sharing, basically doing what I do at tiffintech, but with a company. And why I chose to go down that path is I love doing coding and technical things, but I also love the community building and teaching aspect. And I just felt like in my career, if I looked long term, how I wanted it to progress, it wasn't going purely the technical way. It wasn't purely coding, 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 software development. I was progressing my career in that way, and I just wasn't feeling fulfilled. I felt like there was so much more I could offer into what my skill sets were. And that's not to say you can't have an amazing career being a software developer and growing it that way. It just, I knew I wanted to really find the mix between soft skills and technical skills. Now, to get into developer relations and developer advocacy, what skills do you need? This is a question I get asked a lot. If you don't have developer experience, can you become one? And I think yes, you could definitely become a developer advocate without the technical experience, but it'd be very difficult. Meaning you are speaking to developers, you're often building tutorials for developers, showing code on screen, solving their technical problems. No, you have to be a developer before, I think, at least to some degree, or at least have very strong skills to develop. Maybe you only were a developer for a year or 2 years, but you need something there. And that goes to the next question is, well, do you code in this role? And once again, that can vary company to company. Some developer advocates, as I mentioned, they code all the time, others don't. And for me, how I like to look at it is, you aren't building for production, you are building for other developers. So this might be through doing demos, getting on webinars, with other developer advocates and building a project with them, making video tutorials, answering questions in Discord, different things like that. So you get to still flex your coding skills to varying degrees, but your coding knowledge in this role. And one of the things though that I was nervous about getting into this role is, am I going to lose my technical skills? And I think that's a huge fear that a lot of people have if they're considering going into this role. For me, it wasn't a short-lived fear, I guess you could say, mainly because I have tiffintech, where I do different code with me's, I build cool things, cool technology, cool coding projects with you. So I knew it wasn't something that I would lose, but rather just find other ways to do it. And to me, that was really exciting. So I absolutely love what I do. It is a combination of, as I mentioned, those three pillars. So working directly with the community, if people who are using your product have questions, like developers have questions around it, also to sharing and educating about our tool that we make and how it can be integrated into other projects. The really good thing, the company I work for is called Stackbit, and the really good thing about it is it works with many, many different frameworks. So it's not as though I am honed in on one specific technology. It can allow for many different technologies to work with it, which I really love and get excited about, because then you're speaking to people who are using many different technologies as well. And I think my favorite part of this role is getting to flex, wear many hats, flex different skill sets. And one of the challenging things I would say about this role is around community. You're working towards building a community, but a quality community, I should say. And what I mean by that is quality, essentially, meaning people who are using your product, are excited about your product. Maybe you're targeting a specific group of people, meaning people who work at large enterprises or individual developers who are freelancers. Whatever the case may be, that's what I mean when I say quality, is having a very specific target market and building a community around that. And that is probably one of the biggest challenges, because with that, it's you have to be authentic and find your voice, but also to provide value. It's like, it's a very challenging thing, which is exciting though, an exciting challenge, I think. And that's really what it is. So I'll give you a little insight as to what my day to day, for example, entailed. I started my morning when I started work. It's now I think it's almost six here. So when I started my day, I started with a few meetings. So I met with the developer relations engineer. We meet once a week and kind of talk about what he is working on. He focuses a lot on documentation, and it's really great when we connect because we can talk about how the documentation can be turned into content and shared. And also too, I give him updates on what I'm working on and focusing on for the week. Then after that meeting, I had an outbound meeting. I think that's what it's called, outbound meeting. I met with another developer relations individual at another company, and we are working on building out a demo project that we'll be doing a webinar around using his technology at his company and mine at my company, which is gonna be really cool and exciting. And then I had those two meetings. And then I took some time to work on a video I have been creating around how our product works at a high level. So this is a video that is for developers, for a developer's page we are working on, and it goes a little bit into how to integrate the tool initially with a product, project. Then after that, I had lunch. I had two more meetings, one with a design individual, one with the developer experience person who we connect with as well. He is always building really cool projects, and I always connect with him on what he is working on too. Then after that, what did I do today? After that, I continued on the video. I was working on the How It Works video. And then I did research for an upcoming webinar that we are doing another demo on. So it's a lot of meetings, research, building content. Oh, and then making sure Discord's functioning well, meaning if anyone has a question around it. But this could vary day to day. Once again, it might be more so preparing for a webinar. A few days ago, I gave a demo and it was not targeted towards just developers. So it had to be more higher level, but it's really cool. I absolutely love this role. I think it's a great way to really grow your career. I'm super passionate about growing my career and continuing to level up. Step up, and this just seems like a great balance between getting to interact with leadership and a lot of wonderful individuals, not only within the company I work for, but externally, and build that network, but also to keep your technical skills up. And yeah, I don't know if I did a good job of this. I'm gonna do vlogs of day in the life of a developer advocate. It's just today, this week has been nuts, but a vlog will come soon. And in the meantime, if you have any questions I didn't answer around it, leave in the comments and I will answer them. As you know, I answer every single comment. And okay, it's been a day. I love you all and I will see you all soon. Thanks everyone. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't, by the way.